very often when I begin something to write a piece, it will be probably the adagio. And from the adagio, I go to the beginning and to the end until the end. You know, it's I never compose from the bar one to no. It's a kind of like in cinema, you know, a kind of montage of things. But the adagio, when I am satisfied of slow movement, so maybe the work will will keep, and I work on the other movement.
I hear music, and I hear a human being, and I hear somebody writing something that moves me and touches me. It's got to be a slow movement, doesn't it? I find the slow movements are a joy to play and a joy to listen to. Fast movements are great fun as well, but the slow movements, I think, have great depth and great profundity.
I would say he is the preeminent French-Canadian composer, and I have to put him in that category because he has this French flavor to all of his music, and therefore he belongs to that part of Canada that speaks French. His music speaks French to me.
I think it's a fine and noble thing to produce a body of music that will survive rather than a body of music that is immensely controversial and immensely original and ultimately incomprehensible that will not survive. There are many, it seems to me, there are many composers in Quebec and Canada who will pretty much be footnote phenomena, but that's not going to be Jacques Hetu's fate.
I'm so happy when I compose. It's a way of life for me. I call it work, but it's a work, yes, very hard work, but it's so extraordinary to put these sounds together.